हेलो क्लास सेवन, वेलकम बैक चिल्ड्रन. लेट मी शो यू योर इंग्लिश कोर्स बुक फॉर द एकेडमिक सेशन 2021-2022 फर्स्ट. ओके, नाउ योर इंग्लिश कोर्स बुक फॉर लिटरेचर इज द सेम एज इट वॉज लास्ट टाइम. ओनली द क्लास हैज बीन चेंज. योर इंग्लिश कोर्स बुक इज इंग्लिश रोज फॉर क्लास सेवन बाई मैकमिलन एजुकेशन. ओके, वेर इज इट? मैकमिलन एजुकेशन, राइट? दिस इज योर इंग्लिश लिटरेचर कोर्स बुक. Now, last year we had Radiant Grammar for your English language, which we have changed this year. This year we have introduced a new grammar book, which is from Crystal Books. The book is from Crystal Books Publication, and the name of the book is Modern English Grammar and Composition for Class 7. Okay. So I know many of the students have taken a second-hand book from the seniors. So those, in case you are one of them, so you have make sure that you have the new book of English grammar which I have shown you just now. Okay, now let us talk about assignment. Like last year, this time also you will get your assignments every Thursday. Every Thursday you'll be getting your English assignment, sometimes of literature, sometimes of language. Okay, like last year, these assignments will be scored by us on the basis of how sincerely, punctually, timely, neatly you are doing your work and submitting it. Okay, the quality of the work will also matter. Then you have to be sure that you know your answers are, maximum answers are correct. Okay, then when it comes to the submission part, you have to be very careful when you are typing the email address, because if you type any extra letter or any extra symbol, or if you type a letter wrongly, for example, instead of you can say instead of P you are writing Q, or instead of D you are writing B, then the email address will be not found. Okay, so you'll get a message that address not found. That means the typing part of the email address is done wrongly. Okay, so if you want your assignments to be delivered to the teacher promptly, then make sure that when you are typing the email address of that subject, then it has to be absolutely correct. Okay, any mistake will lead to failure of delivery. Okay, and you will get a message for that. In case you get such a message, check your email address again. Okay, sometimes what happens, the network is slow, or your email shows that it's queued. Queued means it's still in waiting. So on that, you just have to scroll down on that screen, and whenever it gets a free passage, your mail will be delivered to the respective teacher. Okay, now when it comes to English today's class, I'll be starting with English literature, and I'll be doing the first chapter, that is The Open Window. It is a story about a prank that a girl plays on a man, an unsuspecting man. Okay, prank generally you play to some on somebody whom you know, and a person who's very good at lying, who's very composed, and who's very confident at lying, does the prank. Okay, so sometimes that prank is accepted in a sporting way, and sometimes it has such a bad effect on the person on whom it is played that the person either stops talking to you, to the person, the one who has played the prank, or they behave very rudely with, as a reaction to the prank. Okay, so The Open Window is one such story, and let us begin with the chapter, and for that you have to open page number one of your English course book. My aunt will be down presently, Mr. Nuttall, said a very self-possessed young lady of 15. In the meantime, you must try and put up with me. So the story is about Frampton Nuttall, who was suffering from a nerve disorder. That is, he was suffering from the anxiety issue. So when he went to doctors, the doctors advised him that you should go to a place which is very calm, quiet, and there you need to spend months there, a few days there, so that your anxiety issue improves. Okay, so on the advice of the doctor, Frampton Nuttall goes to the village and he visits a house. Okay, so when he goes to the house, ही इज रिसीव्ड बाई अ 15-year-old गर्ल हु इज वेरी सेल्फ पोजेस्ड. सेल्फ पोजेस्ड मीन्स द वेन मिस्टर नटल लुक्ड एट हर, ही फाउंड दैट द गर्ल वॉज वेरी काम, पॉइज्ड, यू नो, कॉन्फिडेंट. शी न्यू हाउ टू, यू नो, रिसीव समवन, इवन इफ दैट पर्सन इज अ स्ट्रेंजर. ओके, सो वेन ही नॉक्स एट द डोर, द गर्ल ओपन्स द डोर एंड शी रिसीव मिस्टर नटल एंड टेल्स हिम दैट माई आंट इज राइट नाउ नॉट प्रेजेंट हियर, शी इज बिजी इन सम वर्क, सो यू हैव टू वेट फॉर हर एंड इन द मीन टाइम यू विल हैव टू पुट अप विद मी. दैट मीन्स पुट अप विद मी मीन्स दैट यू हैव टू बेयर माई कंपनी. आई विल बी गिविंग यू द कंपनी टिल द टाइम माई आंट कम्स डाउन. Frampton Nuttall endeavoured to say the correct something which should duly flatter the niece of the moment without unduly discounting the aunt that was to come. Privately, he doubted more than ever whether these formal visits on a succession of total strangers would do much towards helping his nerve cure, which he was supposed to be undergoing. Now, Frampton Nuttall was meeting the girl for the first time. Okay, so she was a total stranger for him. So when you meet a stranger, you think of what should you say to that person, how you should start a conversation, how you can make that person at ease, okay, how to make that person comfortable. So all those kinds of things were going in Frampton's mind, and he was thinking that how, what words he can use to flatter that 15-year-old girl. Flatter means to praise that girl, okay, and at the same time he was also thinking that that praise, that flattering part should not go over the board, so that, you know, when the aunt comes to know about it, maybe she should not be, you know, uncomfortable with that, or she should not object to that, you know, flattery and all that. So those kinds of things were going on in Frampton Nuttall's mind. And at the same time, he was also thinking that, see, the doctors have told me to meet strangers, you know, and he had the doubt that how meeting strangers in a, you know, totally new place is going to help him deal with his anxiety issue. So all those things were going on in his mind while he was waiting in the living room for the lady of the house. I know how it will be, his sister had said when he was preparing to migrate to this rural retreat. You will bury yourself down there and not speak to a living soul, and your nerves will be worse than ever from moping. I shall just give you letters of introduction to all the people I know there. Some of them, as far as I can remember, were quite nice. When Frampton told his sister that I have consulted doctors about my anxiety issues, and the doctors have told me that you need to go to, you know, a quiet place, so I have decided to go to a village area because it is quite calm and serene environment it has got. It's a very neighborhood is quite, you know, calm and quiet. So I have decided to go to the village, to a village. Now the village where Frampton was going or decided to go was the same village where his sister had lived few years back. So when his sister came to know about it, she knew her brother very nicely, and she knew that he was a very quiet person, a very shy person, and he takes a lot of time to interact with new people or to get friendly with new people. So she knew that how he is going to behave, or how his life is going to be in that village. So she tells him that, you know, I know you very well, and I know that when you'll go to that village, everybody will be totally a stranger to you, a new person to you, and as a result you are not going to mingle around with them. You will take a lot of time to mix around, and because you already have an anxiety issue, you're not going to do that very easily. As a result, most of your time will be spent in loneliness, and your that anxiety issue, your nervous issue will, rather than improving, it will become worse. It will worsen. So to avoid that, what I'm going to do is that I'll write few letters to some of the members of that village, people of that village who have been very nice, who had been very nice to me. So this is what she said, that she's going to write a letter to few of the people who were in the village who were nice to her, hoping that, you know, when he'll give that letter of introduction to those people, they will accept him readily, because they will be knowing that, okay, he is the brother of this person who had once lived in the village. Frampton wondered whether Mrs. Sappleton, the lady to whom he was presenting one of the letters of introduction, came into the nice division. "Do you know many of the people round here?" asked the niece, when she judged that they had had sufficient silent communion. So Frampton was also wondering, he was also thinking that the lady of the house, Mrs. Sappleton, whom he has come to visit, whether that person belongs to the nice people category or not. So he and that 15-year-old girl were sitting in the living area, and that is in the drawing room, and quite a lot of time had gone by, and there was no interaction, there was no conversation going on between them, because both of them were very quiet. So finally the girl started conversing, and the first thing that she asked Mr. Frampton was if he knew people of that area. "Hardly a soul," said Frampton. "My sister was staying here at the rectory, you know, some 4 years ago, and she gave me letters of introduction to some of the people here." He made the last statement in a tone of distinct regret. "Then you know practically nothing about my aunt?" pursued the self-possessed young lady. So when the girl asked Frampton if he knew anybody from the village, Frampton said, "Hardly a soul." Hardly a soul means, he says, "I do not know anyone from this village. Being new, I don't know anyone. I am not familiar with any of the village residents. But my sister used to live in this village around 4 years back, and she was living at the rectory. Now, rectory is the residence of a senior church official. The house where the senior church official lives, stays, is called a rectory. So Frampton says that my sister used to live in the rectory 4 years back, and I'm new in this village, so I don't know anybody, and my sister has, that is why, in order to help me, my sister has written a few letters of introduction for a few of the people of this village who had been, you know, very nice to her." So the lady, the young girl, again asks him that, "You don't know anyone?" He says, "No." Then she says, "That means you don't know anything about my aunt also?" He says, "No." "Only her name and address," admitted the caller. He was wondering whether Mrs. Sappleton was in the married or widowed state. An undefinable something about the room seemed to suggest masculine habitation. So when the girl asks, "You don't know anything about my aunt?" So the Frampton says, "No, I don't know anything about your aunt. I only know her name, that her name is Mrs. Sappleton, and the address, because it is given on, it is written on that letter of introduction," he said. And then he was, you know, at the same time, Frampton was also wondering that he doesn't know, he realized that he doesn't know anything about Mrs. Sappleton. He doesn't even know whether she is still in the married state or whether she is a widow. Widow is a lady, a married woman whose husband has passed away, whose husband has died. So he realized that he doesn't know anything about Mrs. Sappleton, whether she is still married or whether her husband is still alive or has he passed away. So he said, "No, I don't know anything about you." But when he looked around in the living area, there were few items, you can say, or the decoration of the area was such that it made him feel as that there is some masculine habitation there. Masculine habitation means the way the place was, you know, decorated, or things were kept, or there were a few items which gave him the impression that there is a man living in this house. Now, who that man was, whether he was a husband of Mrs. Sappleton or he was somebody else, that Mr. Frampton did not know. Her great tragedy happened just 3 years ago, said the child. That would be since your sister's time. Her tragedy? Asked Frampton. Somehow in this restful country spot, tragedies seemed out of place. When Frampton said, I don't know anything about your aunt, Mrs. Appleton, Vera said, oh, that means you don't even know the tragedy, the mishappening that happened in my aunt's life 3 years ago. So Frampton says, tragedy? Because he was quite surprised. Why? Because village area, you can say village is a very, you know, village community is a very small community where everyone knows everyone. Okay, and they have a very cordial relation. They live very nicely, very friendly, because they need each other. Okay, so that is why the village environment is very peaceful. There are very few quarrels there in the village area, and people live in harmony there. So when Vera, when the girl mentions about the tragedy, Frampton was taken aback. He was quite surprised that in village area there are very few chances of any mishappening happening to anybody's life. So when the girl mentions about her aunt's tragedy, he was quite surprised, because for him village was a place where tragedy hardly happens. Okay, so he was quite surprised because he was not expecting such a, you know, any kind of tragedy in a village area.